Hello everyone, I'm Anjali Ahuja, working as Assistant Professor at DAV Institute of Management, Faridabad. I'm now an Associate Faculty of IIT Bombay for FDP on Foundation Program in ICT for Education. Last year, in 2016, I attended FDP on Use of ICT in Education for Online and Blended Learning, conducted by IIT Bombay. On completion of that FDP with Excellence Award, I got this opportunity to be an associate faculty for future FDPs on use of ICT in education. This year, this FDP is offered in two parts, and we, the associate faculty, or we can say the mentors, are here to offer support and guidance to the participants. For this purpose, I would like to share some of the common questions or queries which might be bothering participants' minds. The first and most important question is, why should a faculty take this FDP? Teachers and students, even in higher education institutions, are still using conventional methods of teaching learning. ICT can be used to support teaching and learning as well as research activities through collaborative learning and inquiring. Whatever ICT tools teachers are using are only limited to understanding and recall level for the students. These traditional methods do not lead to higher order thinking and creativity among students. Use of ICT will help in achieving that. Also, from the perspective of a faculty, there are various benefits of ICT. Like for example, faculty of same domain may collaborate and create a community to pool resources of their domain and can get benefited by ideas and resources of each other. This would become more clear when I'll share with you how has participation in FDP helped me in regular teaching learning practice. I have learned various new teaching learning methods which are based on use of ICT, like flipped classroom. Traditional teaching methods deal with giving lectures in the class and then taking up doubts, whereas flipped classroom focuses on out of class and in class activities separately. The lectures may be recorded in form of videos and made available to students online to watch out of class, so that time of class should not be wasted in discussing the concepts only. Understanding level learning. For recall level learning, various assignments are given along with the out class content which the student is supposed to complete and submit before the class starts. This could also be done through online quiz or test or assignment submission. So, when the student comes to the class, he is well versed with the concept. In-class time is then utilized in higher order thinking activities in which the ideas and views are shared with the peer group. So the full time of class is utilized in a better way. Another teaching learning practice which I adopted is creating open educational resources. I created a website and I keep on adding various educational resources which are open for all. I have made screencasts of various topics and uploaded on YouTube. These screencasts and educational resources are meant for out-class part for students. Other faculty members can also access these resources. All this is making teaching and learning more effective. Now the next question which comes to mind is that how much effort would be required for such FDP? As all are already occupied with workloads, this is major area of concern. On an average, 4 to 5 hours per week would be required for this. All depends upon the content of that particular week and the activities involved. For some weeks, it may be lesser, and for others, it may be little bit more. But not to worry, it is easily manageable. Now, one more important area I would like to discuss here, that is peer assessment. It is most important and integral part of this FDP. The majority of assessments other than quiz are based on this system. The activities or assignments submitted by participants are randomly allocated to other peer participants for assessment. They are supposed to assess the assignments on the basis of evaluation criteria given in the rubrics. But unfortunately, in the previous FDP, it was found that majority of the participants were not doing genuine assessments. Because of that, the scores of various activities got affected. So, this is my request to all the participants that please do genuine peer assessments. These are the ethics in education which need to be followed. Go thoroughly through the assessment rubrics and use genuine parameters for assessing others' assignment. That's all I wanted to share. We are your mentors, your facilitators, and feel free to discuss any problems or queries you find during FDP. All the best for the FDP. Good luck and thank you so much.